Mikvaot, Perek Bet, Mishnah Tet. Ninth Mishnah, the second chapter, Masechet Mikvaot. We're talking about the kankanim. We're still talking about these kankanim, these jugs that you arrange, that you put, they soaked up water. And I want to know, can I use the water that's in them as mikvah water? Meaning I didn't draw the water, I used it to draw water, but the water like seeped into them. So, it says the Mishnah. Hamasader kankanim betoch habor, v'nitmal'u mayim. So I have this bor, this well. I guess the well is sort of filling water from the outside or something like that. It's unclear really, but they're at the bottom of the well and the well is sort of filling up. Now, the reason I put these jugs in the well, I set them up, is because what I want to do is that when I had jugs, I'm going to put wine in them. So the jugs are very porous. They're very absorbent. So now when we make earthenware with wonderful logos, when we make earthenware, the earthenware that we make, it doesn't absorb at all. But then when they made earthenware, it was made of earth, it soaked up. So what you wanted to do was, you wanted it to soak up a bunch of water, make it sort of wet that way, and then you would fill it with wine. Because then then you wouldn't lose all the wine getting soaked up into your jug. Wine was very, very valuable. So you arrange the kankanim in the bor, and then, because you want them to soak up the water, but then vinit mal umayim, they filled up with water. You didn't want them to fill up. I guess my impression is that you filled it up and the bor, the well filled up more than you thought and the water went into it. So now it filled up to a, I need that water for my mikvah. So says the Mishnah, af al pi shebala habor et meimav, even though the bor soaked up its water, hareze yishaver. You are allowed to, hareze, it can be broken. You can break them. Don't pick them up and pour them out. But if you break the jugs because you need that bor water, that well water, that's okay. It says, even though, so it says about Tunur, Ava Bishabala Habor Meimav, in the bor, the bor absorbed the water. Ve'ein Mayim Babor, okay, there's no water in the bor, Ela Elusha Bekankani, meaning it's, what it really means is that it's sucked in the bor water. Harezek Yishaver, you can break it. Kir Rabbi Yoshua, he says, this follows the position of Rabbi Yoshua, De'ein Revit Posa, I mean, even if there's no water, that's what it means, even though Shabala Habor Et Meimav means that, but the Bartanur is explaining to mean that the kankanim soaked up the water in the bor. It doesn't seem to be pshat in balab or meimav, but that's how he interprets it. Not, so meaning, even though there's nothing left in the bor, you can break it. Remember, we learned, Rabbi Lezer says that we're afraid. You can't, you at the beginning, even a revi'it of my misposel. But Rabbi Yeshua said, no, it doesn't matter what comes first, what comes last. As long as it's less than three, then even as long as it's less than three log of mayim she'uvim. But even here, we're saying nonetheless, you can break these jugs. Umishaber teko kankanim. You can break the jugs. Ve'oseh mikvah batchila, and can use this as in original water to fill in, and it's not considered mayim she'uvim. We'll stop here. Dedicate our learning to the memory of my father, Rabbi Simcha ben Yitzchak Kalman. Make it a great day.